What's going on, everyone? Cameron Blazer here, welcoming you to IPSA Week 9. Now, this is kind of awkward because Week 8 did not go up because the video it's broke. I don't know what else to say besides that it's broke. Recorded it. I didn't do a live comm. I just gave up on that. Oh, excuse me, because that was louder than I thought it would be. But, you know, I had just recorded it, and I was like, oh, this is pretty good. Never got to upload it, so. Just some stuff came up, and it just didn't want to upload, did not cooperate. And, yeah, but we're here with Week 9, and I'm not going to have a team builder for this, but WNBL team builder will be up tomorrow, and then the battle will be up Sunday, if all goes to plan, because I have to take the SAT tomorrow. But it's all good. I'm going to do all the recordings tonight and then upload them, so we're good, we're good. But anyways, so Week 8, to give you a recap on what happened, we played Altaria Motives, and we kind of got crapped on because Scrafty lived on 1%, and I believe he had something else live on 1% from Altaria, and we just got low rolls just out the butt. We just could not get we could not catch a break that match, and we still almost won it. But we did end up losing. I think it was 3-0. So we are now 5-3. So after starting off 5-1, we've lost 2 straight. But it's all good. It's all good. We have this match against Automatic. Yet again, we're playing him. If you don't remember, we beat him Week 2, I believe it was, 4-0. On the back of our Celebi, Miss Magius, and T-Tar. T-Tar picked up 4 kills, I think, that match. But as you can see, we're not bringing Mega Altaria, so you guys know what happens every time we don't bring Mega Altaria. But I did it anyways, and we're going to hope for the best. Whoa. Sorry, I do not have a team. My mouse started sliding down, and I just got freaked out. But yes, we did beat him Week 1. And he brings everything except for the Weavile. He brings Gramble instead this time. So we are about to hop into this match. Oh, let me go over my team real quick. I brought a half offensive, half defensive T-Tar this time. I actually predicted him to bring Revile again. Excuse me. And so I decided to bring a defensive one just to handle it. Doesn't have Chopple, so low kick would have hurt, but it did not kill us, I believe, unless he was Adamant Life Orb. It has Stone Edge, Crunch, Pursuit, Stealth Rocks. This thing is, again, it Pursuit traps the Bronzong very well, and it can just hit really hard with Crunch. His only good swap into it is Gramble because of Intimidate. Toxicroak is pretty frail, so it's not going to be taking it. We have Excadrill here, rocking Swords Dance, Earthquake. I have Shadow Claw for the Bronzong and Iron Head. Yep, that's on the bar, right? I believe so. I'm trying not to get my Week 10 sets mixed up. We have a Scarf Celebi with Leaf Storm, Psychic, Hidden Power Fire for... I mean, not Hidden Power Fire, Hidden Power Ice for his Noivern, which he did not bring, and a Shadow Ball for the Bronzong, but he does not bring Noivern. I think he brought Noivern. No, he did not bring Noivern last time, which, I mean, I'm fine with. He didn't bring Noivern. That was one thing that me and Chael struggled against because it outsped. We also have Miss Magius holding the Choice Scarf with a Shadow Ball, Mystical Fire, Icy Wind, Energy Ball, I think is my set. It sounds about right. I should have looked over at the team, but I had to get this done. I'll have to rewatch it, like I said. Look over my team later, I guess. We have Life Orb, Mian Shao with High Jump Kick, U-Turn, Knock Off, and Stone Edge, I think, or something along those lines. Sounds about right. And finally, we have an Assault Vest Electros with Volt Switch, Giga Dream, Flamethrower, and Acid Spray. And so, yeah, we brought the Acid Spray predicting Gramble, and I got that prediction down to the ground, so Gramble can no longer really swap it against me. Pardon me. So, this battle, I 100% expected the, I'm not gonna lie, I said, he's leading Bronzong. I want to get up a free Swords Dance and put a lot of pressure on him. So I Luna lead Excadrill, and we're going to get right into this match. So I lead Excadrill as he actually leads Swampert, so it's not a good lead on my part. We're going to slow this down to normal speed. And I'm going to swap to Celebi because I resist both stabs, and Ice Punch does not kill me. So I'm going to swap to Celebi, and I click U-Turn here, knowing that he's going to swap. And so yeah, we had U-Turn, not whatever else I said. So I'm going to go to Tai Long, and we are going to click High Jump Cake, because he does not have the best... No, I click U-turn. I click U-turn. Knowing that he's swapping. So we do get that prediction down on point. So I'm going to swap to Electros, because this is a good check to it. Player off is not going to 2-hit KO me. We're going to go for the Acid Spray, and he actually is going to update Miss the Acid... I mean, Play Rough, which is kind of unfortunate for him. But, I mean, whatever. We're going to go for another one. I almost clicked Volt Switch predicting the swap, but he does not switch, but I'm going to click the Volt Switch this time, so it's all good. We get a crit, which is, again, kind of unfortunate for him. And we're going to go to Godzilla, and I'm going to see that he does not have Leftovers. So I know immediately he has a Chopperberry. So I'm just going to go for the Pursuit just to break it, because I don't expect him to swap. I really don't. And we do get the Chopperberry to pop, and your Garaball's only going to do 25% because we have no speed investment. And now Crunch will definitely knock him out. And 2-hit KO'd everything outside of the Grave Level Toxicroak, which it did a lot too. And speaking of... Oh, he doesn't go to Toxicroak? Okay. I thought I remember that, but silly me. So we're up 6-5 now. He's gonna click Scald. It's gonna do a good. It's gonna do about 30%, and we're gonna take it. But Ludicolo comes in, and this thing's kind of an issue because it can do a lot to my team. Just it's like an awkward Pokemon, and he's gonna get a crit Scald. Does 55% as I Volt Switch out. Not too worried. And I realized, let's go to T-Tar and get this sand back up. And then I'm going to pull double. I believe I go in... I can't remember what I go into. I know I double here, though. I go into Celebi because I resist both stabs. And as you can see, we drink this energy ball. But we get to take Sandstorm damage. And I believe I click U-turn here. I do. And now we are up 6-4. But he's going to get the momentum because I have to swap. I expected him to swap, but whatever. We go to Mienshell. And High Jump Kick literally blows by him. So we're good there. High Jump is going to do 65%, or it should have, and it did 63, so he's a little more defensive than I predicted, and Scald's going to come off, but we are Regenerator, we're not worrying about that. I believe I click U-turn here, predicting him to swap. Yeah, exactly what he does, I do, and we are going to get our Regenerator up, and we're going to get all that health back. We're going to go to T-Tar. And I know that's a weird thing, but I want to get the sand up to chip him down a little more, and I believe I pull another double. I would swap T-Tar in and get rid of the rain. So I'm going to go to Celebi and Play Rough. He is going to do 49%. I think that's max roll, which is kind of scary. But Leaf Storm kills everything, basically, right now, except for Toxicroak, but Toxicroak's got to swap in. And we're up 6-3, so I'm going to pause right after he sends in Toxicroak. Now, I see an air balloon. And everything's screaming. He's going to Swords Dance, and I can't really swap out because if he Swords Dance, something dies, basically, and I was trying to secure a good win here. I thought I had it in the bag, basically. I was playing very well up until this point, in my opinion. So I told myself I cannot let him set up a Swords Dance for free. I'm going to Leaf Storm, break his balloon, and then go to Excadrill. That was my entire plan. He's going to go for Sucker Punch, and what this means is we can no longer Oko, we literally Oko'd the rest of his team with Celebi, because we Leaf Storm this, and we Psychic this. So I was in a spot where, like, I don't know what to do, because he's going to kill me. Electros is whittled down very low. I believe it's at, I can't view what it's at, but it's, oh, I can, wait, it was at 22%. It's not living. Excadrill can't kill it with Rock Slide or Iron Head. We go into it. And Blair cannot kill because we don't have Psychic this time. I did not expect him. I expected him Weavile over Toxicroak, so that's kind of my bad spot. But I wanted to get the Regenerator up. I know I'm faster, and Sucker Punch won't kill me, so I'm going to click U-turn to break the balloon. And I'm predicting the fighting move, so I'm going to swap to Mienshell. And I make this prediction 100% spot on. He goes for Drain Punch, and we are in a good spot. And I calc Sucker Punch. Max roll is 95%. He gets literally the max roll. That is really not good. That's not good at all. He's adamant, and it's so aggravating. because, like, I know I wasn't going to kill him, but I was going to put him in range where Excadrill is at a point where it would have O-code the Politoed, meaning he can't swap that in. He can't swap Swampert in, because while at speed, he'd have to sack off Toxicroak. It's just not a good situation to be in. So, it's just really bad. So, I mean, I still can go to Excadrill and Oko him, but now I don't have this Magius that can outspeed his Politoed and kill it, because now he goes to said Politoed, and I'm pretty sure I swap here, and I should have stayed in and clicked Earthquake. If I stay in there and I click Earthquake, Swampert takes a big hit, and then I have to sack something, but then I go to T-Tar, and I click, I can then proceed to, I don't know. So, we were up 6-3, and now it's 4-2. So, I mean, it happens. And he's going to Waterfall and kill our Electros. And, it's not much I can do here. I go to T-Tar, and this is the most awkward play I have to be in. So, I'm going to sack off my Tyranitar here. Mainly because all we have to do is go into Mienshao, because it's going to, because he has to swap, basically. It's going to do, like, 90% to this. It'll Oko the Politoed, and then I can swap out, sack off Excadrill, go back into Mienshao, and be in range where Waterfall won't kill me. That's the only way I can win this battle. So Waterfall, he kills Tyranitar. It happens. So I'm going to go to Mienshao and click High Jump Kick, because then we kill everything. We basically kill everything right now. He's going to go to Politoed. He's going to set the rain back up. High Jump Kick comes off, and we miss it. We're going to take that 50% recoil, and at this point, there's absolutely nothing I can do because I cannot get my regenerator up. He claims it didn't matter, but he goes for Waterfall, and it had a chance to not kill. Earthquake, he would have to get absolute min roll, so it's just, it happens, like, it's just, like, aggravating when you're that close. You were up so good, and you just can't hold on because Mega Swampert's really good, and he did a very, very well job keeping his wincon Politoed alive. Politoed was his wincon. If he did not have Politoed, he would have lost that battle easily. Just get blown out, because Excadrill outspeeds without the rain, and so does Mienshao, and between the two of them, Swampert dies. So maybe I should have kept Tyranitar alive longer. It's just my bad, but Waterfall basically killed everything at that point. I could have sacked off Mienshao, gone to Excadrill, he would have killed me, and then I could have pursued it on the... I don't know. It's just, like, there's so much... Like, the thing, a lot of things that could have gone on in that battle, those last, I think, what, 7 turns, was just wild. Really good prep on the Toxicroak. He said it was to set up on my Gastrodon, which almost came, but I swapped it out for Electros, I think, like, 20 minutes before the battle. Because Air Balloon Dry Skin would have just swabbed me, and I would not have predicted that, honestly. That is setup fodder for it, but at the same time, we just have to break the Air Balloon, and Excadrill would have killed it, because Sucker Punch is not doing anything to Excadrill. But, great 9 battle. We are now 5-4. We've lost 3 straight. We went from, what, 5-1, we were 4-0, we were 4-0, and then we went 1-4, not 1-4, yeah, 1-4, we went 1-4 the past 5 battles. We started off 4-0, we've gone 1-4 the last 5, so, you know, I've just, like, ever since, like, I think this just Sun and Moon dropped, I have not done good. I've been on a cold streak. I think I lost 9 straight league battles. I lost 3 here, I've lost WNBL playoffs, I lost WNBL week 1. Update, I lost WNBLC. Oh my god. That's how tired I am, guys. SAT's just gonna kill me. I lost that. I lost SMBL. Just losses everywhere, and it's just so many. I lost PBA, LC, after starting off, which I tried to upload those battles, but after the intro messed up, recap messed up, it didn't Eric. But update, your boy went 4-1 on that entire season and is in playoffs, so we have another playoff belt on right now, and hopefully going to win that championship because our team is kind of great. It has Larvesta, Shellder, Lilip core, which just blows through teams except for flying types beat the entire, just destroy me. Update, if you want to beat me, use a flying type. But, that's all I got. Week 10, against a master. We are out for revenge against him because he was the first person to beat us in this league. Scrumptious. So let's see. Demaster's beaten us. Automatic's now beaten us. Altaria beat us. And Rocker's replacement beat us. So I'm going to refer to him as Rocker's replacement because I cannot remember his name at the moment. I am sorry. Again, it is. I'm tired. My throat does not feel the best. And SAT and it's all over the place. 3 hours of sleep last night. Ooh, smart. So, again, thank you guys for watching. Don't worry. We will be back. We are clinched for playoffs with this one loss update. We lost and clinched. Which is kind of funny to say, but there was a time when I was like at 2-8. I was like, when I lost last week, I was like, dang, if I get blown back next week, I might not make playoffs. But we held him to a 1-0 win, so we are set for playoffs now. We just need to win next week so we can get a good seed. And if all works out, we might be playing, I think, either Hutchigan or Gumby or Fries in the playoffs. And all three, besides Gumby, are really good. Just kidding, Gumby, if you're watching this, I love you. They're all really good battlers. Just hopefully we can just get the matchup we want, and that's Gumby because there's someone we haven't played, and Fries is really good, and I'm scared, so thank you guys for watching. I'm going to stop rambling. I'm going to get about. Be sure to check out Automatic's point of view whenever he posts it, so there's that. I'm going to get about. See you guys next time.